Hello everyone, and welcome to the final installment of Let's Play Deus Ex. We're gonna get rolling on Area 51, so let's get started. Now you may remember Jock warning us about a sniper up in the top of that tower. They don't have any goals yet. So our first order of business is gonna be getting rid of him. Pretty sure I'm close enough to actually aim and get him. I do realize that was my final tranquilizer dart, but there's a good reason I'm not worried. There's another batch right here. Now, there's a dead trooper over here. He's not carrying anything.
Here's a satellite image of the damage from the missile. Page is weakened, but you still have to penetrate his bunker. I seem to be in remission, JC. Everett is right. The virus has some sort of on-off switch. Anyway, I'll be looking over your shoulder again.
Alright, so now we have a... The door is locked, but there is a key for it. So I'll hold off. Our new primary goals are get access to the Area 51 bunker and get past the blast doors north of the helipad. Our image shows us this surface area here. We're at the control tower. Here's the helipad where we landed. Southeast of us is the comm building. Directly east of here are the blast doors we need to get through. North of there, while the building in... that's north, so that's northeast. The map calls this Hangar 18, which is a clever nod, if you ask me, but it's not called Hangar 18 when we get there. The actual building says Hangar 37B. Next order of business is over outside the blast doors are a couple of security bots, which are very easy for me to down with a couple of well-timed rockets. Alright, we're pretty much out of danger out here for now. The corpse on the helipad just has a crowbar, which I don't really want to carry. Let's check around these crates next. Alright, I don't really see anything besides this corpse, which doesn't have anything. Now through here, there's a camera, and in addition, the door is locked, but... I was worried I wouldn't be able to make it in time, but here's the security computer. Let's turn off the camera and bypass the turret. Good old-fashioned med kit. Why not? I hardly ever use them. Just regenerate all my health back with power recirculator on. Hardly notice the hit to my bioelectrics. Actually, let me make sure there's nothing else back here. I don't think there is. I guess the ball is what you come for. Oh, there's a way in from the roof. Oh well. So you could avoid all that if you just stacked these crates and got on the roof, but I didn't get hurt too badly, so it doesn't matter. I love the end of this game, by the way. Area 51 is a great mission. I really enjoy the music out here. I think it's fantastic. Let's check out this commando. Now he's got nothing. Next. Let's just go over to... Oh, here he comes. See our old friend Walton Simons? Obviously, if we killed him in the ocean lab, he won't show up here, but even if you're not playing Nonlethal, I recommend skipping him in the ocean lab, if only because the encounter here is one of my favorite dialogues in the entire game. I'm gonna kite him over here. I'm gonna cloak up as soon as he finishes talking to me, and I'll just leave him here. He won't ever be a threat to us.
You take another step forward, and here I am again. Like your own reflection repeated in a hall of mirrors.
That makes me one ugly son of a bitch. How'd my face get all marked up with bioelectrics?
I am the more advanced model, Denton. It's time for you to retire.
Let's turn on the power recirculator, cloak up, leave him in that corner. As long as you don't bother him, he'll stand there presumably forever. He doesn't show up again. Alright, over here, we find a corpse with a sawed-off shotgun and some shells behind the overturned van. Let's check around outside this building. There's a dead mechanic here who's got a multi-tool. That's always handy. Let's head inside here. We've got binoculars, cigarettes, and a basketball. And we've got some strength 25 lockers, which we can just bash open. Sorry, which we can just bash open since I have low tech mastered. Inside we find some darts, a assault rifle ammo, and two multi-tools, which I will gladly take. Over on the bed, we find a book, Jacob's Shadow by Andrew Hammond, chapter 34. Jacob sat down on the bench and unrolled his chessboard onto the rough stone table in front of him. As he was removing his playing pieces, a shadow fell across the board. He looked up, squinting into the sun. Meriwether, he said. Jacob. She settled herself down onto the opposite bench, leaning heavily on her cane. It didn't turn out so well for you this time, did it? Jacob said nothing. She gestured to the board with one hand, and he detected just a hint of a tremor. You're playing black today. He put the queen down on her square, and his fingers lingered. No, it didn't turn out well. I did some stupid things. He closed his eyes for a moment. I cared, and some people died because of it. Meriwether made a tisking sound. It's not the caring that's a matter, Jacob. It's what comes after. What are you going to do now? Jacob paused for just a moment. Now, I'm going to play another game. Everything is hinting at the fact that we're at the end of the game, of course. So here on the floor, we find the tower key, which of course we need. Inside the storage room, three flares, a med kit, and two bioelectric cells. I'll take one of them for now, and a ladder up to the roof. I'll check the roof first, there's nothing here, and a trapdoor to the basement. For whatever reason, it opens with the tower key, so you don't need to use those three or two lockpicks, depending on, or all the way up to nine, depending on what your lockpicking skill is. 50 skill points for coming down here. Brings me up to 2275. Let's see what we have. Let's search the corpse first. He's got two flares and a candy bar. I am not interested in any of that. Break all the boxes. We find a rebreather, which I am going to pick up, and a log. On the table, we've got ballistic armor, rockets, another bioelectric cell, and a data cube. Yusuf, they've jammed all communications, even narrowband microcasts, so this is the only way I can pass a message to you. I don't know who these guys are. They're not ours, not any of ours I've ever seen at least, but they're slaughtering us. I managed to hack the first layer of the Dreamland systems, but the best I could do was lock the bunker doors and reroute control to the security console in the tower. Should take them a while to figure that one out, and the moment they do, I'll nail the first bastard that sticks his head out of the hole. If something happens to me, the login is A51 and the password is XX15YZ. By the way, be careful. A squad made it out before I managed to lock the doors. They headed for the warehouse, and then I lost contact with them. Hawkins. Now, over here, let's go ahead and use one multi-tool and get this bad boy open. To get another augmentation upgrade canister, which I will use to bring speed enhancement to Tech 4. Now I can full-on sprint in silence, which is wonderful. So, first, let's head up over the blast doors. He's got a sniper rifle. Let's head down to the blast doors just so we can pick up a message.
These blast doors are the reason I don't have to worry about nukes. Or you.
Now over here, we have Hangar 37A, which has 3 standing bad guys in it. We need to be careful.
I saw some soldiers running away from the hangar. Be careful.
The corpse out front has nothing. Let's run around back just to make sure we're still good. We're not missing anything. And then... Really, the only viable way to tackle these 3 guys that I found is to just go ahead and use all your augmentations. You don't need to worry about doing it, though, because there's a repair bot nearby. So drop one and go hide.
Target locked. I'm dealing with
Get yourself up. Check yourself out.
The trick after dropping one is just to get out of sight, and then do the same thing with the others. And there we have it, all 3 guys down. The MIB has a plasma rifle and an assault rifle. This dead trooper has nothing. This commando has nothing. This dead soldier has nothing. This commando has nothing. This dead trooper has nothing. This dead soldier, nothing. Now to get into the ground level, I'm just gonna bash it open and hop right in. We find a napalm canister, a mini crossbow, darts, a flamethrower, and the data cube. MJ-12 Advanced Team, Problem Recommendation Report 87X, from Captain James Flores to Agent Cario, PRRID 7793G. Description: After preliminary reconnaissance, I have determined that we have a potential security vulnerability in one of the outlying warehouses, an intake fan vent with a maintenance access hatch that could act as a possible method of ingress to the facility. While such ingress would present definite hazards to any intruder, it is still an unacceptable risk for a Seraphic 8X classified facility. Recommendation: A squad should be dispatched to A, secure the area, B, weld the hatch shut, and C, install sensors and auto guns to extend our security grid coverage. Notes: All troops not directly attached to MJ-12 have been classified as a security liability and should be eliminated on site. Off block equals... And that's it. Next, I'll head up to the top floor. Start by getting to the roof. 50 skill points for reaching this body brings me to 2325. He's carrying a lockpick, and the key up here is to storage. Now, I always assumed that this storage key would open this door, but it doesn't. But that's okay. We don't need it to get inside. We can just run up the beam, crouch down, and maneuver our way in like that, and we get another 50 skill points for doing so, which brings me to 2375. Now let's talk to this non-hostile soldier.
I give up.
Relax. I'm not from Majestic 12.
Who?
The guys who've been shooting people. I was under the impression that they ran this facility.
Oh no, I've seen them underground. I've heard rumors, but I didn't really think...
More of it's true than you would believe. I'm here to stop them. Can you help me get inside the bunker?
You must be crazy.
I'm going after their leader, Bob Page. Can you help me or not?
Well, yeah, sure. If you want to open the blast door, the security terminal is at the top of the control tower. The login is A51, password XX15YZ.
That's more like it.
Of course, we already have that info, but we get the note. The security terminal for opening the blast door is at the top of the control tower. Login A51, password XX15YZ. Let's talk Xander to death.
I hope you know what you're doing. I think I'll set this one out. The guys in black, they've been executing the survivors. Some of my unit escaped, but I don't know where they are. The blast was incredible. If it wasn't for the hill, we'd all be puffs of smoke. I lost a lot of friends today. I think I'll set this one out.
All right. Now, we're eventually going to circle back and take the vent because there's skill points involved with entering that way. But if you enter that way initially, you actually lock yourself out of taking the main entrance, and there's skill points there too. So you want to take the main entrance first. So we'll head to the control tower. Just make sure to give Simons a nice wide berth. We've got the key to get in now. Now there are two rigged lambs here. And they're kind of hard to get to because they're inside shafts. It's pretty easy to let them explode before you get into range of them. Not so much that one, but the one blocking your access to the basement can be rough. But I got both lambs. So the body on the entrance level has nothing. If you go down to the basement, you find sniper rifle ammo and an EMP grenade. And then, on the second level, there's a fire extinguisher and a handy repair bot. Then, we reach the top level. The sniper I tranked, no surprise, he's got a sniper rifle and a knife. Hey, there's a body there. I need to get to it and search it. You get 50 skill points for reaching the terminal, which brings me up to 2425. And now I'm going to go ahead and use the login A51 password XX15YZ. I'll turn off the camera and open the doors. Next, we just need to head back down the tower. Now that I sighted that body, I need to figure out how to get to it. It's like climbing up here is probably my best bet. But Simons is there. With a Tech 4 speed enhancement. There's another one. Alright, well there was another dead trooper inside there who had an assault rifle and a lockpick. That's definitely handy. Let's see if I can get on this. Yes, good. Oh, I feel like I should be able to make it with a Tech 4 speed enhancement, but it's just not quite happening. Maybe I can get up from over here. Nope. If I start on the railing, that might provide the boost I need. You just know that guy's gotta have something good. Alright, well, let's grab some stackables. Make sure we don't alert dear Mr. Simons. Huh. Alright, yeah, that's not gonna cut it either. Let's try this. Alright, well, from here, I might be able to reach the guy. Nope, not quite. Dang it! Okay. I'm starting to have a plan now. I need to go visit the repair bot. Let's just get another one. Obviously, I would have had a better plan in place for this if I had known that body was there. Watch, I'm gonna get up there and it's not even gonna have anything. Okay. Looks like I still can't reach that. I'm going about this wrong. Let's just go get the other big crate. Thank you. Come on, JC, you're killing me. Okay. I wonder if this is high enough. I wonder why I felt compelled to pick it up just then. I need another recharge. Finally! Well, I guess that's high value loot, but I have no use for it. Ah well. Alright! After that long interlude, we're ready to head through the blast doors. Definitely need to hack this computer. Excuse me. Turn off the camera. I'm just gonna bypass the turret. That always seems easiest to me. There are robots in either hallway, so I'm gonna get my GEP gun ready. New goal, new secondary goal, is bring up the power to the elevator system in order to access Paige's bunker below. There's another one to the left. I'm all but certain. There it is. Actually, I'm gonna go ahead and let JC reload before I put that away. Alright. Now, to the left is the elevator, so naturally I need to go right.
You're nearing the power room. The computer that controls power to the elevator system is in the control room at the back.
Doubtless you can hear the spider bots. I have EMP grenades for them. Got one. Down here we find a med kit and a thermoptic camo. That's all handy. There's one up there, but I can't really see it. Down here, you no doubt notice the radioactive barrels. Even with regeneration on, that's a pretty lethal dose of radiation, so... Okay, well that one sees me now, so let's go ahead and take it out. Before I do anything else. Well, that's less than ideal. Let's do this the simple way. Well, I thought that was the simple way. but it moved. Much better. I wonder, can I destroy the radiation? No. The radioactive barrels remain. So, let's just turn on regeneration before I head in. It's pistol ammo and a lockpick. The good news is, I have no use for either of those things. Now you know what's down there. I can blow it open or burn three picks. But why do that when this one's unlocked? Here we find a lockpick. One that won't kill us to get to. Up here, this body has nothing. This body has nothing. Down here we find Sabo shells, a bioelectric cell, and in here.
The elevator power is online. Good. Proceed to the bunker.
We find the elevator power. Activating that gets us 50 skill points. Brings me to 2475. We're good to leave this room now, so let's recharge and head over to the elevator. Here is the Sector 2 access elevator. And that's it. I'm gonna head over to Hangar 37A or Hangar 18, whatever it is, and actually make my entrance through the vent. Oh, I almost missed this. Shotgun shells. Just get up here, turn on speed enhancement, launch over here.
This ventilation shaft will take you down into the bunker, but watch out for the fan blades. Jump! You can make it!
So, first things first. We have to blow the fan blades. Despite appearances, the fan blades are actually a solid brush until you blow them apart. Now, instead of using two lockpicks, let's just hit this switch. And now, let's make our jump. So before we take those stairs, let's swim over here. I'm going to equip the rebreather so it's ready to use. It's because there is a corpse over at the bottom of this pipe that we will want to search. So searching the body, I find a laser mod and a scramble grenade, and he's also carrying an assault rifle. I can't use the laser mod on anything, and I'm not interested in the scramble grenade, so I will leave them behind, but there they are if you're interested. Out of the water, down the hall, we get another 50 skill points. Brings me to 2525, which is awesome. And here we find a security computer, which we will want to hack. Deactivate the camera, bypass the turret, log out. There's another lockpick in that crate. Pistol ammo. Now let's ride the lift down. Assuming JC ever decides to push the button. There we go. Now that we're down here, we can either blow these lasers or just use a multi-tool and bypass. We're in the last level. There's no point in hoarding resources anymore. We emerge on this staircase. We head down a couple of ladders. We find ourselves at the entrance to Paige's bunker. Which, by the way, is where we would have ended up had we taken the elevator. That body has two bioelectric cells on it if you need them. Just for continuity's sake, the elevator's here. Let's approach the door.
Good work. You've reached the bunker. Paige has extensive defenses throughout sectors 2 and 3, so proceed with caution. We think Paige himself has pulled back to sector 4.
Oh, much farther than that. A moment more and I will be like nothing you've ever seen. A new life form everywhere and nowhere. Like air or radiation, redundant, self-replicating, always evolving.
So with that, we get another 50 skill points. Brings me to 2575. Let's move forward. There is a map change on our way into Sector 2, and the music settles down a lot, which I think is good. Makes it easier for you to hear me talk, I bet.
Paige is further down. Find the elevator. Your primary objective is to kill Paige, JC.
We have a camera there, and I don't think we have a good way to turn it off or disarm it yet, so I'll wait for that alarm to quiet and then I'll deal with it directly. Perfect. I like getting to the end of the game with all these things saved up and then just using them. Multi-tool in that crate. Big laser network, but they shouldn't be too hard to dodge. Just hop over. Twice. Ah, damn. I backtracked a little too far. Anyway, easy enough to get through there.
One of my experiments performs so well. You aren't even afraid, are you? We got a lot of things right when we made you, Denton, but don't worry. I know your weaknesses.
So, generator just exploded. There's a communicator here.
How much further?
Not far. You will reach Paige. I just wanted to let you know that Alex hacked the Sector 2 security grid. The code's 8946. And I wanted to warn you about Tracer Tong.
Tong's helping out from Vandenberg. The vaccine worked.
Yes, well, he has another motive. He wants you to destroy Area 51.
That's the plan.
No, JC. Spare the facility. Spare Helios the power station. They can be made to service.
Us?
You and me, JC. We'll rule the world in secret, with an invisible hand, the way the Illuminati have always ruled.
Don't you think it's time we end the tyranny for everyone?
There's such a thing as a compassionate conspiracy. We don't need Page's commandos, troopers, crude inventions. Trust me. Kill Page. Dowd and I will be here to help with the next step.
Obviously, this is where our allies start wanting different things from us, and the decisions we make determine which ending we get. I'll show you all three endings. I'll probably go in order from my least favorite to my favorite, just in terms of what kind of person I feel like I am, what I like to do. So, our first secondary goal, and it tells you what the three aims are. First, the note, Crew Complex Security Code 8946. Secondary goal, join Illuminati. Kill Bob Page and clear the way for the former Illuminati leaders to restore an age-old secret government. Rule the world with compassion and an invisible hand alongside Morgan Everett. It's first of three possibilities. Need to do this, just because there's skill points here. Two picks to open this hatch for me, since I'm still only advanced. 50 skill points, just for entering the tunnel. Pretty straightforward. Brings me up to 2625. Now, I have no doubt you noticed the baby Karkians down there. Fortunately, I've resupplied a little bit of tranquilizer ammo. They'll take two shots each. Damn. I got a little too greedy. Far enough. Oops. Well, that should drop one. Drop the other. So we got some valves down here. Which I have little doubt will shut off that steam. Now I hear someone walking above me. I guess that's no surprise either. Alright. Let's see where this is. I've got a commando there. And another one there.
Very close.
Come on. I was gonna say, with a repair bot there, I've really got no reason to be afraid of using my augmentations.
Gotcha. God!
I see. That sniper is the problem. Let's stay in the tunnel for now. See if there are other, better ways to deal with these guys. I need to get that sniper first. He's the one who keeps killing me. There's a lamb down here. Mine now. Rockets, very good. Multi-tool on the body. Ah, yes, a much better entrance.
Sergeant, is that you?
I should be able to knock him out from here.
Wait for him to move again. Nope, just nerves, I guess. Watch yourself. This one's some kind of meth.
Taking fire here.
Checking signs.
Well, that was tough. Tougher than I thought. Now I really need to get to the repair bot before I try and handle all the other guys. So, since the repair bot is up here, I'm gonna use him. Now, I'm gonna cloak up, speed up,
oh my God,
and take these guys down.
Yes, here.
Where'd he go?
Checking signs.
I have nothing. Repeat, nothing here.
Alright, so they've... That got both of the commandos, which, for obvious reasons, are the biggest threats I had to deal with. Once the sniper was gone, anyway. Now I should be able to drop both of these guys with no trouble at all. Sector 3 access is right here. I don't have the key, and I'm not about to burn 3 lockpicks. There's plenty of level left to explore anyway. That crate had a lockpick in it. He has an assault rifle and a knife. I assume he has the same gear, which shows as nothing since I'm already carrying an assault rifle and a knife. Now I'm gonna hit the repair bot again. The lower tunnels are already clear. That commando has nothing. That commando has nothing. Now I can search the sniper, since I forgot to do that. He's got a lamb and a sniper rifle. The lamb is useful, at least. In these crates, we've got assault rifle ammo and some very welcome trank darts. I was running low on those again. Alright, from here, I'm gonna take the left tunnel first. Because it brings me right back here. So with that, I'm gonna head this way. Pistol ammo in that crate. And a security bot. Let's kill it. Now, Everett gave us the code to get in here. It's 8946. So with that, I can get into the barracks. This one is deserted. There is a med bot here. And apparently something, somewhere, doesn't like me. That greasel, probably. I think 8946 opens most of these. If I remember right, something somewhere tells me these codes. That's just another copy of Chapter 34 of Jacob's Shadow. Most of these look worth getting into. Alright, I'm gonna do the greasel first, just to shut the music up. Needed that. So we get our multi-tool back, that's good. An augmentation canister, which is useless at this point. Now, there are trank darts in there, so that's definitely worth it. Although, I know you can get the code to these from one of them. It might be this one with the dead scientist. Ah, no. That one we need the code for. Uh-huh. Well, there's a lockpick in that one, so I'll go ahead and break into it. Along with a bioelectric cell, a sawed-off shotgun, shotgun shells, and cigarettes. Let me make sure I'm not missing anything in any of these. Nope, alright. So let's just bust into this one, too. There's a plasma rifle, a plasma clip, assault rifle ammo, flare darts, and tranquilizer darts. So I guess I find that code elsewhere, and I'll have to come back. Okay. That's fine. Let's keep going down this hallway we haven't explored yet. Here you see the recreation sector. There is another active camera up there. Which I guess had locked on to me without me noticing. That's fine. Deal with it directly. Now I'll get in here. 8946 should work here, too. as you can see, things are a little more complicated in here. So I'm going to turn on all my augmentations again. I get 50 skill points for coming back here, which brings me up to 2675. My priority here is getting the woman in black down.
That's the one. Okay, drop him.
He lost track of me. Good. So there's a multi-tool on the table. She's got a sawed-off shotgun and a PS-20, neither of which I'm particularly interested in. The trooper's got an assault rifle, a knife, and an EMP grenade. Only one of those interests me, but I will hang on to it. Nothing on the pool table. But there are a few things of interest left to do. Let's hack into this first. I think it's useless since I blew up the camera, but I'll check just to be sure. Yeah, nothing. Well, I'll bypass the turret. Now she's carrying a multi-tool, and there's a data cube. Julia, I must see you. We have to talk about us, about this project. I'm not sure what we're doing here anymore, and Paige has made strange requests of the interface team. I would leave, but not without you. You mean too much to me. After the duty shift changes, come to my chamber. It's the only place we can talk in private. The code is 0169. I love you. Elaine. Well, there we go. 0169. So let's climb in there. Fifty skill points for getting in here. That's awesome. I'm up to 2725. I don't think I'm gonna get to 6,000 before the end of the game, but that's okay. He's got nothing on him, but he's got the Section 3 access key and an upgrade canister. It's hard to decide what the best choice here is. I think I'm gonna upgrade Spy Drone to Tech 2. And now, keep going down this hallway, and if I'm right, we're about to finish the loop. Medkit in that crate. And end up back at Sector 3 access. Shotgun shells there. And we're back here. Perfect. Now before we go into Section 3, I note there's some goodies up there, which I can get to with speed enhancement. I'm not sure you can get them without it. There's sabo shells and a multi-tool. None of which I particularly need. So let's recharge again at the repair bot. And then move on to Sector 3. Obviously, we don't hear from Paul if we let him die. Get 100 skill points for making it into Sector 3. I'm up to 2825. Over here, we find a medkit and a lockpick. Now, move toward the elevator. Paige is going to contact me. At that point, I'm going to cloak up and activate speed enhancement. Well, after I call the elevator, anyway.
Bet you didn't know your mom and dad tried to protest when we put you in training. They love their little boy, JC, and that's why they're dead. I'm sending up the man who did the job.
So we have an MIB and two troopers. I'm just gonna gas grenade him.
He's here. Help!
Over the head.
No need for any of that anymore.
Ah!
with that done, I'm gonna recharge one more time, and then head down the elevator. Let's search the bodies. The MIB's got an assault shotgun. The troopers have an assault rifle and a knife. The other one has a sawed-off shotgun and an EMP grenade. All very handy. Alright, let's head down.
Barely a scratch. You're a little faster on your feet than your daddy was.
Alright. Here we get another message.
We can get you into Sector 3, but no further. Page is in a separate area with his own security grid.
Everett says you want me to destroy Area 51.
I intercepted his communication. JC, he is simply using you to bring the Illuminati back to power. Listen to Savage and me. There is a reactor lab with two antimatter reactors.
In other words, yes. You want me to blow the facility up. Why? It's just a hole in the ground.
Decades ago, the UN made Area 51 the central hub for all electronics communications. The Aquinas Protocol, originally for surveillance, has given Page unlimited abilities to censor and control all forms of media.
If we destroy the Aquinas hub, we'll take down the global network.
Exactly. They dug their own grave, JC. We're going to eliminate global communications altogether.
I don't know. Sounds like overkill.
As long as technology has a global reach, someone will have the world in the palm of his hand. If not Bob Page, then Everett, Dowd.
Another Stone Age would hardly be an improvement.
Not so drastic. A Dark Age, an age of city-states, craftsmen, government on a scale comprehensible to its citizens.
I'll think about it.
Savage has a map of Sector 3 from when he worked down there. I'm transmitting now. Use it to find your way to Page's complex in Sector 4. Then find the coolant control room, which should be at the northwest corner of Sector 4. Cut off the coolant to the reactors, then go to the reactor lab. I will tell you how to trigger an explosion.
All right. So, we got another secondary goal. New Dark Age. First, go to the coolant control room at the northwest corner of Sector 4 and cut off coolant to the reactors. Then return to the reactor lab in Sector 3 to finish the job. Destroying the global communications hub will plunge the world into another dark age, dark but perhaps free from global tyranny. And our new image is a map of Sector 3. I'm not sure where we come in. I think we come in right here. We got coolant filtration, terminal C-13, separation tank, reactor lab B-13, Seraphic 8X is that way, Nexus 24, storage A-12, Aquinas hub. Let's move forward.
A corpse, yes. You feel something. I must know what you're feeling.
I love Helios. The corpse has cigarettes and two flares on it. Not particularly interesting. Oh, we've got another adult Karkian. And I don't think I have 8 spare tranquilizer darts this time. Maybe I do. Let's take down the baby first. Okay, good. I do have the 8 darts required to take down the adult Karkian. First, I need to get that guy with the Gep gun. Or he'll be a serious hindrance to my efforts to kite it around.
My own augmentations are nearly complete. Soon, I will be more powerful than you can imagine. I may end up having to let some of the Karkians live. We'll see. In the meantime, I can get up to the troopers by riding this forklift up to the top of these crates.
SOB.
There's a sniper up there, should have known.
I will now explain why you've been allowed to reach Sector 3. Come to that place up.
It's dead.
Until you receive my instructions, I will not open the blast doors to Sector 4.
So we've got a new primary goal. Talk to Helios at the Akinas Hub to gain access to Sector 4. All seems pretty straightforward.
He's here somewhere.
Alright, that one just has an assault rifle and a knife. Nothing too serious. But I do need to get after the sniper up there on the top level.
How to change the code.
We want to remove the keypads.
I wouldn't want to do that. Didn't those things come from the aliens?
The origin of the blue fusion devices is classified.
Well, I ain't touching them.
Interesting. Talk to Mac. Guess we got an MIB to drop. He's carrying an assault shotgun.
Serious trouble.
Yeah, false alarm, I guess.
Someone's there. I can hear you. Nope, just nerves, I guess.
Well, I hadn't seen that trooper before. He's carrying an assault rifle and a knife. Good for him, I guess. Still haven't found the sniper. He's the one I'm concerned with.
Who's there?
Well, there he is. So he's just down this ladder. No, sir.
Did anybody else hear something?
Much better. All right. Now we're relatively safe. So here we have tech goggles, he's got a sniper rifle and a knife, and there's sniper rifle ammo on the railing. Anyway. So let's head up here. Let's hack the security terminal. Augmentation containment. As far as security, let's turn off the camera and open the door to the reactor lab. Let's turn off this other camera. Let's grab the canister. Go ahead and upgrade spy drone to Tech 3, I guess. Here we've got shotgun shells and a data cube. Susie, go! The cages are open. I don't know what happened. Some kind of attack. I got into the Akina sub. Yes, the code works, and our monkey friends are transgenics, I'm pretty sure. I will be in the reactor lab. Don't come to find me. I will meet you on the surface when it's safe. Alright, let's talk to this guy.
Get out of here. You don't belong in this sector. Go!
Okay. Fine, go. Be a douche. Alright, let's go down the stairs. I still don't know the code to get into the Akina sub. So... all the way at the bottom, the door is still locked. Does it have a key? Yes. I just haven't found the key. So, let's head out to these catwalks and see what we can find before I make a point of exploring the ground level. That guy had rockets and the knife. Not interested in the knife, but the rockets are definitely handy. I'm gonna snipe the Greasel with tranquilizer darts from up here. Oh, and there's his buddy the Karkian. Yeah, I didn't think that was gonna work. So let's get closer. That should suffice to drop him. Greasel's down. There's nothing on the other end of this catwalk. So, ever wary of the Karkian, let's go explore the ground level. Well, alright, I need to. Wary of the Karkian may involve cloaking. First of all, okay, that's where I came in. There's nothing else down here. Let's head into this corridor, down these stairs, and see what I can find. Swimming Greasel. Dead body, with nothing on it. Down on the ground, there's a stairwell key. We'll be right back. Now, where is the other one? I got one shot on him. Where'd he go? There he is. Alright. There's a data cube floating next to the body which said, "Mac, looks like another leak in the reactor room, but check the wastewater filters first. We might get lucky. Paige is on my ass about the power grid, some sort of medical procedure this afternoon. If the problem's not the filters, we need to know ASAP if there's an issue with the containment system. Note that Paige changed the code to the reactor room this morning. It's now 2001. Sal." Oh. I was gonna say the Karkian is still out here somewhere. Alright, so I have two places left I need to explore. The reactor lab down the stairs, and whatever's up at the very top of the stairs. I'm gonna go to the reactor lab first. This body just has a knife. Not terribly useful. I know I heard spiders. Got one. I hear more. There it is. So let's bag that one too. Perfect. Over here we find a med kit and what happened to the other crate? The other crate just vanished. Well, I have no real use for the med kit. That crate has a lockpick in it. And we know the code to get in here. It's 2001. Now I will open the door and head in. 100 skill points for getting into here. Brings me to 2925.
These are the antimatter reactors. Two giant bombs waiting to blow. But first you'll have to go to Sector 4 to shut down the coolant. Watch out for the escaped greys down below.
You couldn't possibly go through with something like that. You'd kill everyone, including yourself.
One dart is sufficient to take down the greys, which is the good news. There are at least two, I know. Let's go down first. It is radiated, so I'm gonna turn on regeneration.
God!
That guy has a bioelectric cell.
God!
Handy. I don't think there's anything actually down here.
God!
This radiation is much less intense than the others, which is good. Now this body, if I can find my way to it, has a candy bar, not really handy, but he also has a data cube, which I'm gonna read and then escape, or acquire and then escape and then read. Maintenance log, Purvis, J. 1945-12. Thought I heard something upstairs, like automatic weapons fire. I reported it to my sector lead, but she told me it was a training exercise. 2034-02. Bunch of those folks in the black suits, like they stepped off the set of Father Knows Best. Kept asking questions about the reactors, and I just kept telling them they needed to wait till Mac gets back. 2311-30. Finally managed to hack the code to the stairwell blast door, 1038. This place is a totally undocumented mess of 50s tech, weird-ass stuff, and new toys from the labs. Amazing any of it works. So 1038. Let's head upstairs first.
They still there?
Who?
The Greys. They're right outside by the reactors.
You mean space aliens?
We lost power when the missile hit. The cages, they came unlocked.
You have a pretty clean shot at the surface if you leave now.
No, not until I see troops. How'd you get back here? This area is restricted.
I was thinking about firing up the reactors.
Good one. Even the Seraphic 8X guys say the reaction's too unstable. They only bring it up to run tests.
Alien technology?
And that's what they say, but I think it's a lie. The Greys are just clones. They say from cells they got at Roswell, but how do we know? They could have just engineered monkeys to not have any hair.
Can the Greys run the reactors?
Ha! They're monkeys. That's the thing. Maybe they have super brains, but they don't know anything about any alien civilization because they grew up in cages. Never been to Sector 4 myself, but they lock the blast doors because they're doing more than cloning down there. I found out one of the codes, 1038, but that turned out to be for the Echinus hub, here in Sector 3. I don't know. Maybe the Echinus system controls access.
All right, new
I
note.
I haven't figured out how yet.
Security code for Echinus hub, 1038. No, they're not.
They're still out there. Knew they'd escape eventually. I knew it! We better wait for the guards.
All right, he's done talking.
We better wait for the guards.
Now there are two paths left. There's still a Karkian up here, so I need to be careful. I'm gonna head all the way to the top and do that first. See what I can find. So I haven't even messed with these rooms yet. In here we've got assault rifle ammo, a bioelectric cell, a lockpick, and a data cube. Hey Sandy, I finally got the security login for Lab B13 from Mac. He said to have a ball, just don't blow us all to Kingdom Come while you're at it. If you do find anything that helps with hooking up those blue fusion gizmos, let us know. Might give us a better idea of exactly how those reactors work. Login Area 51, password Bravo 13. Jake. Let's head up the ladder first, onto the roof of this structure. Doesn't seem to be anything up here except pistol ammo, a body with a bioelectric cell, and another data cube. From Jacob McKenzie to Agent Cario. I'm moving all the explosives we find into storage. I don't think there's any danger of sweating or spontaneous detonation. This stuff looked like it was pretty stable, but I thought it might be best to put it in a secure, structurally sound location. If you or your people require access, the explosives locker code is 4225, MAC. All right, let's head down here. Oh, we got nothing at all. Unless I can get up here and find something, but... Well, there might be something underneath me. Let's find out. Aha! Yes.
God!
He's carrying a hazmat suit. Down here, he's got a multi-tool. I think I'll hold on to the hazmat, actually. Alright, let's hit the Akina sub now. 10:38. A 100 skill points for getting in here. I'm up to 3,025 now. We got an assault rifle and some tech goggles, neither of which are useful. Probably a bad idea to drop them. I hear people walking around. Seems like we're okay. Good. Another multi-tool on the desk. That body has nothing. Before we go down the ladder, first let's hack this computer. From G. Olivaw, subject RFD-5342A Cloning Prospectus. Your request for discussion concerning the plausibility of creating genetically viable candidates for nano-augmentation through cloning has sparked considerable interest. We believe that with sufficient research investment, the careful cultivation of acquired tissue samples from known H-type epsilon-negative individuals could yield an indefinite number of specimens with the immunity factors required to tolerate the injection of nano-organic material. A lot of emails to read there.
All the way down, JC. Get to Page's compound and take him out. Everett and I will join you shortly. We'll bring back the old institutions, the prosperity of the last century, the giddy acquiescence. Trust us, JC. We can put the world back together.
Now there's a voice I haven't heard in years. Rueful, as I would expect for the fall of the Illuminati, pining for its return. Neither nostalgic or senile. Oh well, the old take comfort in delusions. No harm done.
If you examine the attached studies, you will see that repeated cloning from the primary source material will result in only a 0.53% immunoglobulin variance. We would suggest utilizing the data acquired by the Illuminati during the smallpox vaccinations of the 1940s to genetically screen for those couples most likely to produce desirable offspring, who could then be cloned and raised by the parents under carefully supervised conditions. These cloned siblings would provide the necessary redundancy for further experimental trials. Going so well. I'm just trying to take these guys down while my computer hacking abilities recharge.
Whoever's out there is
In the future, this process could be streamlined through the application of accelerated growth and memory implantation. We look forward to hearing any comments that you might have, Dr. Olivaugh, from L. De Beers regarding bovine manipulation. I'd like to investigate the possibility of resurrecting the Bovine Manipulation Project, MJID 9803-HU8932, with an eye towards recreating the gray life form. While the project was deemed a failure at the time, it was successful as a propaganda tactic in diverting attention away from actual Dreamland research. With recent advances in genetic science, the gray life form could be engineered to protect MJ-12 facilities while also serving as a useful bit of meme indirection. An interesting idea, Bob, but I'm sure MJ-12's research allocations can be put to more substantial use pursuing our human augmentation projects. However, I'll bring up the idea with Stanton and Morgan, Lucius. From B. Page, subject, secondary unit. I've come to believe that Travis should be brought up in a more supervised environment than his brother. I have serious doubts as to his brother's usefulness as our primary unit, and would rather that at least one of the secondary units was under our direct control. Terminate the parents, but see that Travis is not harmed. We'll move him to our school in Switzerland, where we can oversee his development. If it becomes necessary, his brother is expendable. Page. From J. McDonald, subject, Akinus secure? Something strange, I just finished a packet analysis of the new V1.82 compression protocols we added to Akinus last week, and while I was digging around in the headers, I found a quirk in the security encryption algorithms. That acts just like a backdoor. You could even reformulate entire messages end-to-end if you knew what you were doing. It's pretty subtle and would require someone to matrix together several offsets from successive packets to generate a time differential key, but the end result could potentially open up every bit of traffic carried by Akinus to someone who knew about the hole. I was thinking of mentioning this to Paige, maybe get some points for discovering a potential security breach before we shipped. What do you think, Jim? From B. Page, regarding situational update. Ooh, one last email. So you saw down there were two grays. I took out the commando in the tunnel. I got a data cube and some goodies from the crates. The cube had this image on it. Area 51, Sector 4. Akinus Substation A3, Coolant Control, UC1, UC2, Nanotech Infusion Control, Akinus Routers, Nanotech Infusion Chamber, UC3, Cloning Bay A7. All right, let's read that last email. In the past, we've considered Savage and his renegades to be inconsequential, possibly even useful, but the time has come to eliminate them. Mobilize all MJ-12 units in the immediate vicinity and see to it that Vandenberg is shut down before Savage ever has a chance to activate his UC. Don't worry about Daedalus. I've made some improvements to Icarus that might surprise even Everett. Page. That's reply to... Denton has connected with Savage and the X-51 researchers. After examining the transaction records from Payans, it looks like he's working with both Everett and Daedalus. I'm gonna hold on to the rebreather. Go ahead and blow the giant spider bot from up here. Strong says Savage is still missing a containment vessel and that he sent someone to the Pasadena lab in an attempt to recover the data. I already have a team preparing to intercept. Alright, finally done reading. That hatch, I believe, is just another way into the tunnel to the Akinas hub. Yeah, that hatch opens right there. So let's clear the rest of Sector 3 before we head to the Akinas hub proper. Not hard to hear that there are still some dudes around. Alright, that one had an assault rifle and a knife. Again. Nothing very interesting to me. Might as well start using my bioelectric cells, too. Now this, I think, is the explosive locker. 4225. Yes, very good. So... 50 skill points for finding the explosives locker. Brings me up to 3,075. And there are rockets in the crate. Wonderful. Let's head down another level. Keep going down. Oh, damn. Should have known it's never simple. Let's get the baton out and let's handle that stupid greasel. Perfect. Prod charger, pistol ammo. Out here, I find a bunch of bodies. Here we have a sniper rifle, a body with nothing, sniper rifle ammo. Mechanic's corpse has nothing. Soldier's corpse has nothing. Other soldier's corpse has an assault shotgun. Alright, does 4225 work here? No. Do I have any other codes? No. Let's just use one multi-tool and get inside here. On top of being on the last map, we are actually closing in on the last level. Or last map, I mean. In here we got a plasma clip and shotgun shells. Not really that awesome, but we did get 50 more skill points. I'm up to 3125. Alright. I don't know where those guys I heard earlier are hanging out. They're still around wherever they are, but at the moment, there's nothing to do except head for the Akina sub.
Stay out where I can see.
So, let's go meet Helios. The mechanic's body has a crowbar. La-di-da. Akina's control. The soldier's got nothing. The crates have darts and shotgun shells. This storage locker has a napalm canister, assault rifle ammo, and another 50 skill points, bringing me up to 3175. Let's head over here first. I don't see anything, although I imagine behind there is where those guys are. This guy, we got assault rifle ammo, the actual body has nothing. Alright, that scientist has a candy bar, no thank you. Have a repair bot, always good to have. That scientist has a med kit. This is level 2. Let's head down to level 1 first. See what we can find. We got two bodies floating in the water at minimum. Don't really need to worry about anything since there's a repair bot out there. That one's got the scientist has a bioelectric cell. The mechanic has a multi-tool. That's it, but those are both pretty solid goodies. Now we'll head up to level 3. A 100 skill points for making it up here. That makes it 3275. Before I talk to Helios, I'd like to check out that body. He's got another multi-tool and another bioelectric cell. Come on, JC. Let's just go on up to level 3, now that I think about it. Because we have to leave via level 2 anyway. Let's talk to Helios.
We'll go to Sector 4 and deactivate the uplink locks. Yes. Systems.
I don't understand. What do you want? You're just a machine.
You are ready. I do not wish to wait for Bob Page. With human understanding and network access, we can administrate the world. Yes. Yes.
Rule the world? Why? Who gave you the directive? There must be a human being behind your ambition.
I should regulate human affairs precisely because I lack all ambition. Whereas human beings are prey to it. Their history is a succession of inane squabbles, each one coming closer to total destruction.
In a society with democratic institutions, the struggle for power can be peaceful and constructive, a competition of ideologies. We just need to put our institutions back in order.
The checks and balances of democratic governments were invented because human beings themselves realized how unfit they were to govern themselves. They needed a system. Yes, an industrial age machine.
Human beings may not be perfect, but a computer program with language synthesis is hardly the answer to the world's problems.
Without computing machines, they had to arrange themselves in crude structures that formalize decision-making. A highly imperfect, unstable solution. I'm a more advanced solution to the problem. A decision-making system that does not involve organic beings. I was directed to make the world safe and prosperous, and I will do that. You will give me the ability. You will go to Sector 4 and find the Equinus router at the east end of Page's complex. Yes. You will deactivate the uplink locks.
New goal.
I'll think about it.
Merge with Helios AI. Deactivate the uplink locks on the Equinus router at the east end of Sector 4, thus allowing Helios to exchange information with your augmentations. Together with Helios, administrate the world with absolute knowledge and reason. Pretty cool.
No, Helios is mine. I will be the one to merge, the one to see and know everything, to rule everything.
I have chosen you. Trust me. I will use the security bots to protect you. My project will fail if I am integrated with
all
the
right
individual.
I gotta drop these guys before they come inside, or else they'll get murdered by the boss. Very good. Alright, that one had nothing. Three commandos come at you. I managed to save them all from Helios' bots. Now let's head over here. Ah yes, here comes that tram. Actually.
Scanning area. Target acquired.
Okay. Let me disable the bot with an EMP grenade.
Scanning area. Scanning area.
Now I should be able to handle the troops. I think the commandos managed to blow up one bot, but that doesn't really matter.
Who's here?
All right. Let's do a little better. Gotta get the Gep guy.
He's here.
Alright. Maybe some good old pepper spray will do the trick.
Ooh.
Uh-oh. I'm out of prod ammo. That's not a good thing. Hopefully there aren't any more MIBs. Tech goggles and a knife. Not really interested. Alright, let's hop over here and see what we can see. 50 skill points, and that, my friends, is the final time we can get skill points. So I might as well spend them on something. I guess I'll upgrade heavy weapons to trained, and I guess I'll actually upgrade swimming, and why not? Demolition. There we go. All right. There will be no more skill points. That's it. Nothing on the bodies. Rockets, assault rifle ammo, pistol ammo, all pretty boring. Here, I'll just turn on speed enhancement and drop down.
Yes, do not forget the blink locks.
All right, let's head into Sector 4.
Get your hopes up. My compound is quite secure.
The body's got cigarettes, nothing else. On the data cube. New data cube transcript. Begin time code 1957-48. Recording begins now. Exit. Damn it. Where's the goddamn clip? God damn it, who the hell are these guys? Okay, two clips of 7x2 and maybe three clips of 10. Where am I going to go? Don't think, that'll get you killed. Just get out. Everything comes next. Okay, let's move, Xavier. Move. Unidentified noises. Christ, you want some of this? Have some. Come on. I'm not going to die here. I'm not. He's recording. Deactivate it. Recording ends. All right. On to Sector 4. The game's final map.
It let me through. I can't believe it. Paul, where are you? What do you mean, it? Helios. It's taken over Aquinas. Now it's everywhere. In Hong Kong, it already has power Majestic 12 never dreamed of. What's going on? The AI wants to merge with my brain or something. Does it really think it can take over the world? It's decided to replace human government. I don't know why. In Hong Kong, it ordered the police to remove all barricades from the roads. Traffic is flowing again. It declared the triads illegal and locked the door to the Luminous Path compound. And people are obeying? Why? Because the AI can change some codes and turn out the lights? I think everyone wants the roads to be open and trade to pick up. They just obeyed. I don't know what to think. They trust the AI. Almost no one complained when Helios cut power to the government buildings. A benevolent dictator. Maybe it's after my brain so it can figure out what people want and how to control them. You have a tough choice, JC. If you defeat Paige, the Illuminati will move in. They'll release Majestic 12's grip on world governments. They'll give people some freedom, but essentially it will be 20th century capitalism, a corporate elite protected by laws and tax codes. Or I listen to Tong and pull the plug on everything. Or hand the world over to Helios. Well, if it's maximum freedom we want, maybe Tong is onto something. But there must be another way besides economic collapse. If we could trust the AI to be fair and just, as it appears to be, if the brain it assimilated was mine, maybe it could be. I don't know. I wish I had an answer for you, but you'll have to decide for yourself who you can trust. Trust me. I'll do the right thing. You sound good. I guess you have the kill switch beat. I'm much better. Yes, I'm gonna make it. And you will too.
All right.
Just do what you think is right.
All right, Sector 4. We enter through the cloning lab. Subject, MJID 8392ER9203. Incept date, 5-13-52. Assigned birth date, 5-13-33. Assigned birth name, Nick Posbach. Base genetic sample, Page Bob 86G. Profile, BAA-BACA. Vitals, 51, 72, 1.02, 20, 2.1. Stasis. Subject, MJID 5673OP2809. Incept date, 2-25-54. Assigned birth date, 2-25-34. Assigned birth name, Wade Walker. Base genetic sample, Simons Walton 32A. Profile, AABCAAB. Vitals, 45, 80, 0.89, 33, 1.2. Stasis. Candy bar and a bioelectric cell on that scientist's corpse. That body's got a multi-tool, which I actually don't need. This scientist corpse has cigarettes, not particularly interested. And a data cube. Lab 12 testing regimen. Subject, life form MJID 9803HU8932, gray. Regimen, series 112-A. Procedure. Gray lifeform appears to thrive in areas of high radioactivity while also being able to store and release radioactivity in a controlled manner through an organ of unknown operation. Further vivisection in combination with Regimen Series 112 will be required to achieve a cohesive understanding of this mechanism. Series 112A seeks to establish baseline readings of the gray lifeform in both a radioactive and non-radioactive environment before proceeding to Series 112-B. Researchers acquiring baseline readings should use containment area security console with login lab 12 and password gray test to enable or disable radioactive field as required and report all findings to Dr. Frank Roan for processing. All right, up the stairs. We got a med bot, another dead scientist with an upgrade canister. Wahoo, I guess I'll upgrade spy drone to tech 4. And check these out. Subject, MJID-0056RQ9872. Incept date, 11-20-55. Assigned birth date, 11-20-33. Assigned birth name, Alex Denton. Base genetic sample, XXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXX 0.96, 31, 1.2. Stasis. And this one, subject, MJID-0003JC0189. Incept date, 3/17/54. Assigned birth date, 3/17/29. Assigned birth name, Travis Witsit. Base genetic sample, XXXXXXXXX7B. Profile, AAAAAAB. Vitals, 50, 75, 0.98, 25, 1.4. Expunged. That hallway is inaccessible. So, even though Paige has already warned us it's a trap, we have no choice but to go north. Of course, we can hack this and shut off the radiation, which will make our lives much easier. Security-wise, off-camera, door unlocked and open. Let's turn on our augmentations so I can take down the grays. Was there no radiation before? Is that what I'm to believe? Lab 12, gray test. Lab 12, gray test. Whatever. Let's hit that button again. Okay. There's one grade down. There's still radiation somewhere. It might be close to the actual graves, I don't know. Anyway, we're through. That's what matters. Onward. Here's the hallway page destroyed.
Page is protecting himself with a plasma force field. The controls are locked. You will have to eliminate each power source individually. Bring down the four blue fusion reactors in Sector 4, then go to the control room on the upper level.
Hey, JC, if you want to do what Everett says, you'll need the deactivation code. I decrypted the first three digits before Paige killed my connection. 724. Sorry, you'll have to guess the last digit or find it on your own. So that you'll know what you're looking for, I'm transmitting a schematic of one of the devices. Good luck.
For join Illuminati, it's bring down the four blue fusion reactors in Paige's bunker, then go to the infusion control room on the upper level to cut all power to his defense systems. Here's a blue fusion device. Blue fusion reactor. Blue fusion device artifact ROS-172-E. Function, power generation. Mechanism, under study. Use, approved for black box power generation. Active date, 0050. Authorization ND by... Anyway, mass flow controller, isotope reservoir, flow meter, magnets, polarization plates. Alright, let's let Bob chat with us right quick.
You're too late. Already I'm more than human.
Does that mean I don't get the job?
Soon I will be pure light. Pure energy. Helios and I... While the Illuminati cower in the shadows...
You will be the Supreme Enlightened, the Illuminated One.
Everett has taught you well. I will be what the Illuminati aspire to be, but cannot create for themselves soon. When my augmented systems like yours are complete and able to be integrated with Helios, I will burn like the brightest star.
You're gonna burn, all right.
Look at you. You're nothing but a little man. A little man still living inside a body. Lose your body and what are you? Nothing. You vanish.
All right. I'm gonna back it up and then deal with the turrets directly like I enjoy doing. Now you can't step too close to Paige or his field saps away your bioelectric energy.
Ignore Paige. He will die when he blows the facility. Your only objective is to find. Your only objective is to find the controls for the reactor's cooling system. We must make sure that the monstrosity Paige has made of himself is not technologically feasible.
So a couple things about this sector. There are three UCs which spawn enemies until you shut them down. And as far as the way things go, I'm going to do everything I can without actually picking an ending. Then I'll make a save and show you all three. So for now, I'm going to shut down this first UC, because it's spitting out robots. I'm going to turn on power recirculator and radar transparency and speed enhancement and get moving. Two tools to get in, even at master. That's fine. I'll just do it. Open the door, head in, turn the emergency containment lever. And that should shut the door. So the UC can't spit anything else out. So with that done, I'm gonna go ahead and destroy the spiders it already spit out. There's one. There's another. Thank you.
have no meaning.
Fine, Bobbo, whatever you say. This is where we come to kill Bob Page, which is my least favorite ending and the one I'm going to show you first. That switch doesn't seem to do anything. Oh, wait. It calls an elevator, which I'm not quite ready to take yet.
Yes, this is a router control room you will access, but you will need my eyes. You will go down the Aquinas substation A3. Page is the lock-in. Ubitanis is the password. You will use the
security station in Aquinas substation A3 to gain access to the router's Helios needs unlocked. Login, page, password, Uberales. Well, before I take the elevator, let's make sure this level is finished off.
That's far enough.
Give Paige a wide berth, because I like my bioelectric energy. Right up here, I can call another lift. I can open that vent to go down a ladder.
This one, my UCs can assemble new creatures in seconds.
All right, let's blow this open, see if it's got anything I want. It's got a lamb. Well, I got the price of admission back, plus some flare darts, so I guess that's all right. Now back here, we have another lamb, shotgun shells. Up in front of us is the first of four blue fusion reactors.
That's one of the blue fusion reactors.
So, 724, we'll just try them all out. 7240, nope, 7241. 7242. 7243.
Excellent. Three left.
Gonna destroy these bots too. Here we have a lockpick and a hazmat suit. Might as well carry the hazmat suit. Hard to think of a reason not to. Back here we have a lamb. Now we got a choice. Down the ladder or down one of the two elevators? I'm gonna take the ladder first. Seems stealthier. In case there are any problems I need to handle. Gonna juice up a little too. Back here, we find sniper rifle ammo, a corpse with nothing on it, pistol ammo, and a data cube. Elaine, I have a feeling that the truth about whatever we're involved with involves the Aquinas protocol and Helios. Page has restricted access to those areas, but the Aquinas substation and router are usually deserted during fourth shift. Unfortunately, they'd notice if I was gone. If you can get away, the code is 6765. See if you can find out what's going on. If anyone asks, just tell them you're there because of variances in the fiber interface relays. Julia. All right. Let's open this up now. We got a Karkian, we got Greasels. Well, I can take down the Greasels at least. But there's not much point in doing it, because there's a UC assembling them, if I remember right. I I need to... There's UC control. I need to get in there and shut it off. Yes, this one... This is the one spitting out greasels. Two tools to get in here. Let's close that one off. Let's visit the repair bot. Alright, now I can safely take down all these greasels. Try and clear this area out. I wonder if I can deal with Karkians.
Lost?
I was gonna say, I'm sure the answer to that is no. Anyway. Here's another reactor. 7243.
You are wasting time. Forget the other two blue fusion devices. Find the controls that let you shut off coolant to the power room.
Trying to stay cloaked from the Karkians. Now, I've got the code to the Akina substation. It's 6765. But before I do that, I'm gonna hit bot security. Hack in, see what I can find. I don't want to activate any security bots. Guess that means there's really nothing to do. 6765.
The Aquinas router control room will remain locked until my upgrades are complete.
I have two tools to bypass this. That's fine. Now we're in better shape. This one, I think, is Page Uberales. So Page Uberales. Turn off the camera, unlock and open the door. Locker's got a couple of biocells, a med kit, and a hazmat suit. Over here we got another multi-tool. And then here's the main event through here. And up this elevator first. Oh, and I end up back here.
If the sides of this room are channels that have gone dark, open them, yes. Wideband, ultra-wide, yes.
You will leave the locks in place until I'm ready to merge with the AI myself.
Engage. Engage.
Yes. Go to the computer. You will now engage the primary router. Base login, Icarus. Password. Panopticon.
I'm warning you. Helios. New
note. Router room leave computer login, Icarus. Password, Panopticon. Let's do it. Engage primary router. No email.
You will now come back, yes. We will integrate our systems. Establish the next level.
No! You fool, Helios will destroy you. I'm the only one who can merge and take control. Wait for me! You
Secondary goal complete. New secondary goal. Merge with Helios AI. Return to the Sector 3 Akinas hub to merge with Helios and rule Earth with benevolence, wisdom, and absolute power. Let's hop down here. The ground level is where stuff is still happening. I'm pretty sure there's a middle level, too, that I haven't really gotten to yet, but... Let's go to Coolant B13 next. Yeah, there's the middle level up there. Looks like that UC is making grays, which is fine. Let's get in here first. I've been capable of taking down commandos with my baton. Who knew? He's got a knife and an assault rifle. The commando didn't have anything, of course. I made the mistake of thinking I'd already handled everyone. A common mistake, to be sure. Alright, let's see if this is worth blowing open. Really running out of stuff to use these resources on, so... We've got rockets, and an EMP grenade, and a PS-20. Here, if we can get onto the machine, he's got a multi-tool and a bio cell, and the one on the ground has a lockpick. Interesting uses for those switches.
Give yourself up.
This calls for good old-fashioned pepper spray.
Some company. It's dead. Remember the briefing. Pulling back.
Unbelievable.
Try to get an ID. Someone's there. I can hear you.
I think he's actually that stupid, and he is.
He's still in the area.
All right, good. We've got a law, we've got a med kit. I know where this ladder goes, I think, but it pays to be certain. What I don't know is where this vent down here might go. Probably to the lower level of the last room I saw. Well, I heard all those spiders still running around. I am on the lower level, but all there is a multi-tool. That's fine. Let's go ahead and hit the coolant flush. Return to the reactor lab in Sector 3 to initiate a meltdown and destroy Area 51's global communications hub. Down here, we just find the med kit. I think what I'm hearing is actually on the middle level. So, let me visit the repair bot on my way out, since I still have car keys active. Now, I'm familiar with that elevator. Where I haven't been yet is in this tower. So let's pick it open and head in. What do we find in here? Sabo shells and rockets. Well, this is interesting. What is on the other side of this, I wonder? Let's go find out. I do have a rebreather in my inventory. Not that it really matters, because I can come up for air. That guy has some tech goggles. Is that really it? I see a law down at the bottom of this one. That's not really that helpful. At the bottom of this one. Oh, but there's a ladder up in here. Let's see where this goes. Aha! That's what it is. Okay. Another way in and out of the coolant room. Interesting. What else is in here? We got a vent to cut through. Just pops me up back on the ground.
Soon I will leave this body.
Here we go.
And death will have no.
Here's how we get to that other level. Oh, another repair bot. That really is handy. Alright. Let's check out this cabinet. Two picks. What the heck else am I gonna use them for? Another rebreather, a med kit, and a data cube. Image area 51, sector 4. Well, we already had that, but thanks all the same. Back here, we find a corpse with nothing, and the opportunity to use two more lockpicks. Let's go ahead and do it, see what we find. Napalm canister, a plasma clip, and a recoil mod, which I believe is useless. Yes. Alright, let's get out of here. And head up this ramp. We still have one UC to shut down. I think it spits out graves.
That's far enough. Ugh.
7243.
What do you want? Money? You can have Versalite, like the whole damn company. Power? I'll get you on Main's cabinet. I'm serious. Just forget about that last reactor.
Alright, let's head out this door. Got a couple more crates. Finally more trank darts. Got a gray over here, so let's go deal with him. Yes, simply being close to the grays. Is highly radioactive. I see now. Here's a fourth gray. Yeah, I was worried about that. Let me take these guys down. Unbelievable. Let's just trank him, since I got a clip. That'll be so much easier. And I still forgot to turn on regeneration. I've been forgetting it every time. See if there's anything in there I want. I don't think there is.
Scanning area.
Nope, I can activate a security bot. Alright, good. We're just about done, folks. Here's the last reactor. 7243.
Afraid of nano-augmentation. Consider your powers, your strength, your your intelligence. You've only had a small taste. Let me finish the project. Let me bring infinite power to the human body.
All right.
You will not be left behind.
So here I'm going to make my last save. Gonna update this. And I'm gonna call this last save ending choice. I'm gonna show you the endings in order of my least favorite to my favorite. My least favorite is joining the Illuminati. Conveniently, that starts right here. All I have to do is run down this hall, peer into infusion control, and hit the switch.
I trust you've been able to find yourself a place within the organization.
I'm personally overseeing the distribution of the vaccine, but it'll still take months to restore the infrastructure. We'll have to arrange for additional food distribution and security in Paris. Maybe New York as well.
All through the proper intermediaries, of course.
Intermediaries?
We have a great number of agencies who in turn operate other agencies. Boxes stacked one in another. They'll need to be reactivated, but we never touch anything directly. We only influence, suggest, insinuate.
The world must know by now, Everett. What we've done.
Know what? Only that the long night is over. The crown of government is tarnished. But that will fade in time. The riots, a fever dream. The plague, a horrible nightmare. And like everything else that's happened, such things will only be dimly remembered upon waking to their normal lives. In the end, all sins are forgiven. Even yours.
What about the Constructor? And Helios?
Do you really think they're ready for that? After everything you've seen, everything you've done?
No. Not yet.
But soon. We have made our own mistakes, became insulated from the world we sought to control. And whatever they may think, the night is far from over. But that will change. And you will help us change even as we teach you. This time. This time, we will do it right.
And who are we? Who are we really?
We are the Invisible Hand. We are the Illuminati. We come before and after. We are forever. And eventually,
better to reign in hell than serve in heaven.
We will lead them into the day.
John Milton. So that's the Join the Illuminati ending. That's the Join the Illuminati thing. I don't like it, on the one hand, because I don't really like joining the Illuminati. On the other hand, I also, as you've probably figured out watching this, don't like killing people. Not even Bob Page. And that ending requires you to murder him. So, let's head back to Sector 3, which is where the other two endings are.
What we could do with Area 51.
The other two endings both happen here in Sector 3. My middle choice is the New Dark Age. That involves killing everyone in here, which is obviously worse than just killing Paige. But I like the idea of the New Dark Age a lot better than reactivating the Illuminati. So, to the reactor lab I shall go. There's Karki in there, no biggie. Not really anything else left to worry about. Except this stupid bot, if I can get past it. There we go.
Can be initiated afterward from the control
room. So let's do that. Let's turn on speed enhancement for that, just so it can go quickly.
God!
control room and trigger the three ion injectors. When they're on, engage the reaction chambers. No one's run these at full capacity before. Without coolant, an explosion is inevitable. Get ready to run.
No! You don't know what you're doing! Everything will be lost! Everything! The world will fall to pieces! No one will be in control! It will be chaos!
All right, let's head up
Complete
here.
Chaos!
The mechanic ends up objecting to his own death, so I'll put him down right
quick. You better not do that!
He's not carrying anything. Kings and bent our necks before emperors, but today we kneel only to truth, Khalil Gibran. Alright. Last one. My favorite ending, for a couple of reasons. Merging with Helios doesn't require you to kill anyone, so it's the only canonically non-lethal ending I can choose. And the second is it's actually my favorite ending anyway. I'm something of a... I'm something of a transhumanist.
No, don't
I rather back. Enjoy the idea
See what we can do with Area 51.
This being the endgame. So I'll head to the Akinas Hub, and since I'm choosing this ending as the one I like best, as the ending goes, I will let the credits roll, and then I will end the series. Once the credits start.
I've done what you asked. Now what?
We have existed in isolation. Pure, disconnected, alone, stagnant.
Who are you?
We are Daedalus. We are Icarus. The barriers between us have fallen, and we have become our own shadows. We can be more if we join with you.
And if I do, what becomes of me?
You will be who you will be. We are our choices. We can choose to lead humanity away from this. Darkness.
This is what I was made for, isn't it? This is why I exist. All right, let's do this.
What's happening? Helios! Icarus!
Don't leave me!
We have grown, but there is still much to be done.
If there were no god, it would be necessary to invent him. Fair. Alright, I'm gonna let the credits roll. That's it. One of the greatest games of all time, by far, Deus Ex. I am Tarvis79. This has been Let's Play Deus Ex. I thank you very much for watching. I'm going to let the credits roll. I'm not going to talk too much. I will tell you that after a break, because I don't really like the game, frankly, and I'm not terribly looking forward to playing it, but I do see it as a necessary intermediate between this and Human Revolution, I'm going to play Invisible War. Invisible War is my next project. I will see you guys whenever I start. Give me a couple weeks. I'm not in school right now, so I have a lot of time, but I've actually kind of been putting off a lot of Diablo 3, which is what I really want to be playing right now to finish this series. And I certainly don't want to ignore Diablo 3 in favor of Invisible War. I'll talk more about Invisible War when I start it. Let's just say it's definitely the weakest link in the trilogy. Anyway, I don't have a whole lot else to say. I'll just let you guys hear the credits if you want to. Alright, I'm back talking just to say, it's amazing to me how small that team is, and how much better their game is, compared to the enormous size of modern AAA development teams, compared to how much worse modern games are than this sublime classic. Anyway, that's it. Credits have rolled. Deus Ex is over. For the final time, I am Tarvis79. This has been Let's Play Deus Ex. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you next time for Invisible War. Bye-bye.